Good morning, students. Welcome to All Fours online classes. Okay, right? This is Srinivasachari, Botany faculty, working in All Fours NEET Academy. All Fours NEET Academy, right? Today we are going to discuss some important terms in botany. Right? I think you are familiar with these words. But once again, I am drilling these words, right? First one is a petiole. Second one is a pedicel. And third one is a peduncle. Right? Go for the first one. What is petiole? Sir, what is the meaning of a petiole? Petiole means a stalk. Sir, it is a stalk of what, sir? It is a stalk of a leaf. Therefore, stalk of leaf is called as what? Petiole. Now, see here. For example, this is a stem. What it is? Stem. Sir, on stem, this is node. What is this one, sir? Node. At this node, a leaf has developed. This is stem, this is node, and okay, right? Sir, this is leaf. This leaf is with stalk or without stalk, sir? It is with stalk. This stalk of leaf is called as a petiole. Therefore, what is the meaning of petiole? The stalk of leaf is called as a petiole. Now, observe this leaf carefully. Sir, this leaf is with petiole. Leaf with petiole is called as petiolate leaf. Leaf with petiole is called as what? Petiolate leaf. Therefore, I am taking a leaf, sir. Is it okay? Right. Sir, this leaf is with petiole, sir. This leaf is with petiole. Then we are calling that leaf as what, sir? Petiolate leaf. Is it okay? Right? Now listen here. Sir, take a leaf. For example, this leaf is without petiole. Here we are assuming a leaf not having a petiole. That leaf without petiole is called as a sessile leaf. What is that leaf called as a sessile leaf? Therefore, leaf without petiole is called as a sessile leaf. Is it okay? Right? Therefore, what is the first word here? Petiole. What is the meaning of petiole? The stalk of leaf is called as petiole. It is a stalk of leaf. Called as what? Petiole. Is it okay? Right? Now, a leaf with petiole. What is that leaf called as? Petiolate leaf. Leaf without petiole is called as a sessile leaf. Is it okay? Right. Now go for the second word. What is pedicel? What is the meaning of a pedicel? Right. Now see here. For example, this is a axis. What is this one? Axis. On this axis, this small leaf-like structures are called as a bract. What is this leaf-like structure called as a bract? Is it okay? Right? Therefore, what is the meaning of bract, sir? Bract means it is a small leaf-like structure. What is the meaning of bract? Small leaf-like structure. Is it okay? Now see here. Sir, this is axis, sir, and this is a bract, sir. From the axil of this bract, right, a flower is developed, sir. What is developed? A flower is developed. From where this flower is developed? It is developed from axil. This is called as axil. What it is called as? Bract. Therefore, flower is developed from axil of what, sir? Bract. Is it okay? Right? Sir, I am calling this one as axil. This one as what? Bract. Therefore, flower is developed from where, sir? Axil of the bract. Is this statement okay? Right? Now, see here. Sir, I am saying this one has flower, right? Now, see this flower. This flower is with stalk. This flower is with what, sir? Stalk. This stalk of flower is called as a pedicel. Stalk of what? Stalk of flower called as what? Pedicel. Therefore, what is the meaning of pedicel, sir? Pedicel means a stalk of flower. Stalk of flower is called as a pedicel. Is it okay? Now see here, sir, this flower is with pedicel or without pedicel? It is with pedicel. Flower with pedicel is called as a pedicellate flower. Therefore, flower with what, sir? Pedicel. Flower with pedicel is called as a pedicellate flower. Which flower? Pedicellate flower. Therefore, pedicellate flower means that a flower is having pedicel. What is that flower called as? Pedicellate flower. Now, you assume a flower or you take a flower. For example, that flower is without pedicel, sir. For example, that flower is not having pedicel. Then what is that flower called as? That flower is called as a sessile flower. What is that flower called as a sessile flower? Therefore, see these two words carefully. Sir, pedicel. What is the meaning of pedicel? The stalk of flower is called as a pedicel. This flower is with pedicel. Therefore, flower with pedicel is called as pedicellate flower. Whereas a flower without pedicel is called as what, sir? Sessile flower. Now, listen the statement. Sir, leaf is sessile if what is absent? If petiole is absent. What is absent? Petiole is absent. Then we are calling leaf as a sessile leaf. Sir, flower is sessile if what is absent? Pedicel is absent. If pedicel is absent, flower becomes sessile. If petiole is absent, leaf becomes sessile. Is this statement okay? Right. Now, go for number 3. What is the third word, sir? Peduncle. Right. Is it a peduncle? No, it is peduncle. It is peduncle. Sir, what is the meaning of peduncle? Do you heard the word inflorescence? Is it familiar for you? Inflorescence. Inflorescence. What it is? Inflorescence. What is the meaning of inflorescence? Inflorescence means a group of flowers. What is the meaning of inflorescence? A group of flowers. Listen to the statement. Sir, this is an axis. What is this one? Axis. What are all these bracts? Right? From axil of bract, what are developed? Flowers are developed. From where? From the axil of bracts. What are developed? Flowers are developed. Now see this diagram. In this diagram, one flower is there or group of flowers are there? Group of flowers. What we are calling this group of flowers as are inflorescence. This group of flowers is called as what, sir? Inflorescence. Therefore, what is the meaning of inflorescence? Group of flowers called as inflorescence. Is it okay? Right. Now, see here. Listen here. Sir, this group of flowers, they are present on a common axis. See here. There are many flowers. All these flowers are present on a common axis. Sir, what is this common axis called as? We are calling this group of flowers as inflorescence. Then this common axis on which flowers are present, this common axis is called as inflorescence axis. What is called as inflorescence axis? Then where is the peduncle, sir? This inflorescence axis is also called as peduncle. What is another name for inflorescence axis? It is also called as peduncle. Is it okay? Right. Now, what is the meaning of inflorescence? Group of flowers. Group of what? Flowers. Called as inflorescence. The common axis of inflorescence. The common axis of inflorescence is called as inflorescence axis or peduncle. Inflorescence axis or peduncle. Therefore, I think you got these three words. What is the first one? Petiole. Stalk of leaf is called as a petiole. Number two, pedicel. Stalk of flower is called as a pedicel. Number three, peduncle. Inflorescence axis is called as peduncle. Inflorescence axis is called as what? Peduncle. Inflorescence axis is called as peduncle. Right? Now, what is the meaning of a radicle and a plumule? What is this radicle and a plumule? Radicle and what? Plumule. Now see here, take a seed. Generally, a seed contains two parts. A seed is with how many parts? Two parts. Sir, what are the two parts of a seed, sir? First one is a seed coat. What is the first one? Seed coat. And second one is a embryo. What is the second part, sir? Embryo. Therefore, a seed contains how many parts? Two parts. What are they? First one is a seed coat and second one is what, sir? Embryo. Now, diagrammatically, I am representing a seed. Now you tell me, a seed should be with how many parts? Two parts. What are the first one? Seed coat. Sir, this is seed coat. Right? What is the second part, sir? Second part is a embryo. What is the second part? Second part is a embryo. Embryo. Is it okay? Right? This yellow part is a embryo. There is this white layer. This is what, sir? Seed coat. Is it okay? Right? Therefore, a seed is with how many parts? Two parts. What are they? Seed coat and second one is what, sir? Embryo. Now see here, I am saying this as embryo, right? Sir, a embryo contains two parts. Embryo is with how many parts? Two parts. Embryo is with how many parts? Two parts. What are the two parts of an embryo, sir? First one is a embryonal axis. What are the first part? Embryonal axis. Embryonal axis. And second one is a cotyledons. I think you heard these words in your 10th class also, right? What are the two parts? Embryonal axis and second one is cotyledons. Sir, embryonal axis and cotyledons, these are two parts of what, sir? Embryo. Sir, in this diagram, right, this line, it indicates embryonal axis. What this line indicates? Embryonal axis. Whereas these two indicates cotyledons. What these two indicates, sir? Cotyledons. Sir, in the diagram, I can see the embryonal axis, sir. I can see the cotyledons, sir. Then where is the embryo, sir? These two together forms embryo. Therefore, embryonal axis and cotyledons together forms what, sir? Embryo. Together forms embryo. Is it okay? Right. Now listen, sir, what is this line indicates? It indicates embryonal axis, right? Now you tell me, sir, this is lower end of embryonal axis or upper end of embryonal axis? This is lower end of embryonal axis. This lower end of embryonal axis is called as radicle. Which end? Lower end of what? Embryonal axis, called as what? Radicle. Now see this one. Sir, this is upper end or lower end? This is upper end. Upper end of what? Embryonal axis. This is called as what, sir? Plumule. What it is called as? Plumule. Therefore, if you see the embryonal axis, in this embryonal axis, right, the lower end is called as a... Which end, sir? Lower end is called as a radicle. Lower end is called as radicle. Whereas this upper end is called as a plumule. Upper end is called as what, sir? Plumule. Now, see here. Sir, radicle. Radicle develops into root system. Radicle develops into which system? Root system. Whereas plumule develops into shoot system. Plumule develops into which system? Shoot system. Sir, what is the meaning of a shoot system? Stem is present, leaves are present. stem plus leaves along with the branches called as what, sir? Shoot system. Called as what? Shoot system. Is it okay? Right? Now, see here. Sir, this is a seed. In general, a seed is with how many parts? Two parts. What are they? Seed coat and embryo. A seed is with how many parts? Two parts. What and what? Seed coat and embryo. Right? Sir, embryo is with how many parts? Two parts. What are they? Embryonal axis and cotyledons. Embryonal axis and cotyledons. These are two parts of an embryo. Right? Sir, embryonal axis. This is embryonal axis. This is embryonal axis. The lower end of embryonal axis is called as radicle. Radicle develops into root system. The upper end of embryonal axis is called as plumule. Plumule develops into which system, sir? Shoot system. Now, what left in this diagram? What are these two? Cotyledons. What are these two? Cotyledons. Now, listen to this statement. Sir, these cotyledons are storage organs. In general, what are these cotyledons? They are storage organs. What are the storage organs here? Cotyledons. Now, see this diagram carefully. Sir, in this diagram, how many cotyledons are present? Two cotyledons are present. If two cotyledons are present, it becomes a dicotyledonous seed. A seed with two cotyledons. Called as what? Dicotyledonous seed. We are calling it simply as dicot seed. Right? For example, in a seed, if only one cotyledon is present, then what is that seed called as, sir? Then it is called as a monocotyledonous seed or monocot seed. Therefore, a dicot seed, name itself indicates, di means two, cot means cotyledons. Therefore, seed with two cotyledons, dicotyledonous seed. Seed with one cotyledon, monocotyledonous seed or monocot seed. Is it okay? Right? Now, listen here. Sir, based on number of cotyledons, based on number of cotyledons, seeds may be, what they may be? They may be either monocot seeds, right? Next one is dicot seeds. Which seeds, sir? Dicot seeds. Sir, mono means how many? One. Cot means what, sir? Cotyledon. Therefore, seed with how many cotyledon? Seed with one cotyledon. Such seeds are called as monocot seeds. Sir, di means how many? Two. Here, cot stands for what? Cotyledons. Therefore, how many cotyledons are present here? Two cotyledons are present. Therefore, monocot seeds are with one cotyledon, whereas dicot seeds are with two cotyledons. For example, you take rice. What, sir? Rice. Number two, wheat. Number three, maize. These three examples are familiar for you. Yes or no? Right? Rice, wheat, and maize. These three are monocots, sir. These three are monocots means in each rice seed, right, how many cotyledons are present? One cotyledon. In each wheat seed, one cotyledon is present. In each maize seed, one cotyledon is present. Now you take dicot seeds. Best example for dicot seeds is bean. What is, sir? Bean. Best example is bean. Even you can take red gram also. Number of examples are there. Red gram also you can take. Black gram you can take. Right? Almond you can take. Yes or no? Right. Therefore, best example for which seeds are dicot seeds is what's a bean. Is it okay? Right? Therefore, radicle. Which end of embryonal axis? Lower end of embryonal axis. Develops into what? Root system. Then what is the meaning of plumule? Upper end of embryonal axis is called as plumule. Develops into which system, sir? Develops into shoot system. Now, listen here. heard this word angiosperms? What it is? Angiosperms. And second one is gymnosperms. Go for the first one. What it is? Angiosperms. Sir, angio means enclosed. What is the meaning of angio? Enclosed. In angiosperms, sperm stands for seeds. Sperm stands for what, sir? Seeds. Therefore, sir, what is the meaning of angiosperms? Angiosperms means here what are enclosed? Seeds are enclosed. Sir, we are saying that in angiosperms, seeds are enclosed. Seeds are enclosed. They are enclosed inside what, sir? They are enclosed inside the fruit. What are enclosed? Seeds are enclosed inside the fruit. Seeds are enclosed. Where? Inside the fruit. Seeds are enclosed inside the fruit. Is it okay? Right? Now, listen this statement carefully. Sir, in angiosperms, seeds are present or absent, sir. I'm saying that enclosed seeds are present here. It means here seeds are present. Seeds present. Sir, seeds are enclosed inside what, sir? They are enclosed inside the fruit. It means here fruit is present or absent. Fruit is present. Here fruit is also present. Therefore, in case of angiosperms, seeds are present as well as fruit is present. Seeds are present as well as what, sir? Fruit is present. Is it okay? Right. Now go for gymnosperms. Sir, what is the meaning of gymno? Gymno means naked. What is the meaning of gymno? Gymno means naked. Sperm stands for what, sir? Sperm stands for seed. I already told this word. Sperm stands for what, sir? Seed. It means here what are naked, sir? Seeds are naked. What are naked? Seeds are naked. In which plants? Gymnosperms. Sir, in gymnosperms, why seeds are naked, sir? Because in gymnosperms, fruit is absent. Therefore, seeds are naked. Seeds are naked as what is absent? As fruit is absent. What is absent? Fruit is absent. Is it okay? Right? Therefore, gymnosperms, right, having naked seeds. Your seeds are naked. Why seeds are naked, sir? Because fruit is absent. What is absent? Fruit is absent. Is it okay? Right. Now listen here. Sir, what is the first one here? Angiosperms. What is the first one? Angiosperms, right? Sir, this angiosperms, right? This angiosperms are again classified into dicots and monocots. Classified into what and what, sir? Dicots and monocots. Dicots and monocots. Now see here, sir, in case of dicots, seeds are present, fruit is present. Because dicots comes under angiosperms, I already told you. In angiosperms, seeds are present as well as fruit is present, right? Therefore, dicots, fruit is present, seeds are present. Sir, monocots also comes under angiosperms, right? Therefore, in case of monocots also, fruit is present as well as seeds are present. Therefore, in dicots and monocots, fruit and seeds both are present. As they comes under what, sir? As they comes under angiosperms. As they comes under what, sir? Angiosperms. Therefore, is these two words clear? Right? Angiosperms and gymnosperms. Now, take a angiospermic plant. Which plant, sir? Angiospermic plant. Sir, in case of angiospermic plants, sexual reproduction takes place with the help of a flower. Which reproduction? Sexual reproduction. With the help of what? Flower. In which plants? Angiospermic plants. Therefore, in angiospermic plants, which reproduction? Sexual reproduction takes place with the help of what's a flower? Is it okay? That's why we are calling flower as a sexual reproductive organ of an angiospermic plant. Who is called as a sexual reproductive organ of an angiospermic plant? Flower. Flower is called as a sexual reproductive organ. Sexual reproductive organ of an which plant? Angiospermic plant. Is it okay? Therefore, flower is described as a sexual reproductive organ of which plants are angiospermic plant. Is it okay? Right? Now, listen to this statement. Sir, angiosperms, these are plants, right? Sir, do all plants contain flowers? No. All plants are without flowers. Right? We cannot say that all plants are with flowers. Right? But angiosperms, are they with flowers, sir? Yes, angiospermic plants are with flowers. So, angiospermic plants are commonly called as a flowering plants. Which plants? Angiospermic plants. Commonly called as what, sir? Flowering plants. Therefore, angiospermic plants. Angiospermic plants. Angiospermic plants, they are generally, angiospermic plants are generally called as a, angiospermic plants are generally called as a, which plants, sir? They are generally called as flowering plants. Angiospermic plants are generally called as a flowering plants. Is this statement okay? Right? Now, listen here. Now, take a flower. See, here diagrams, they won't be attractive, but here diagrams are scientific. Diagrams are scientific, they are self-explanatory, right? It means if you see the diagram, you should get the concept. Diagrams should be like that. Then it will be useful for you also, right? Now, see here, this is a diagrammatic representation of a flower, right? Now, you tell me, what is the stalk of flower called as? The stalk of flower is called as a pedicel, right? Stalk of what, sir? Flower. Called as what? Pedicel. The stalk of flower is called as pedicel. Then, what is this cone-shaped structure called as, sir? This is a tip of the pedicel. What is this cone-like structure? Tip of the pedicel. This tip of the pedicel is called as thalamus. 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 Therefore, tip of the pedicel is called as what, sir? Thalamus. Tip of the pedicel is called as a thalamus. Is it okay? Right. Now see here, if you take a flower contains number one, calyx. Number two, corolla. Number three, androecium. What it is? Androecium. Number four, gynoecium. Is it okay? Right. Sir, a flower contains calyx, sir. Calyx. It contains corolla. Corolla. It contains androecium. Androecium. It contains what, sir? Gynoecium. Therefore, calyx, corolla, androecium, and gynoecium. These are four parts of a flower. These are four parts of a flower. Is it okay? Now, listen here. In these four parts of a flower, calyx and corolla, they are not directly involved in sexual reproduction. Are they directly involved in sexual reproduction? No. What and what? Calyx and corolla, they are not directly involved in sexual reproduction. That's why this calyx and corolla together called as non-essential organs of a flower. Essential, non-essential, they are non-essential organs of a flower. Who are non-essential organs of a flower? Calyx and corolla. Now go for androecium and gynoecium. this Andrewsham and Gynesham, they are directly involved in sexual reproduction. Sir, how you are saying that Andrewsham and Gynesham are directly involved in sexual reproduction, sir? Sexual reproduction involves fertilization. During sexual reproduction, what takes place? Fertilization takes place. Fertilization means the fusion of male gamete with female gamete. What is fusing with what? Male gamete is fusing with female gamete. That male gamete is produced by Andrewsham. Who is producing the male gamete? Andrewsham. Whereas the female gamete is produced by Gynesham. Who is producing the female gamete? Gynesham. Therefore, male gamete produced by Andrewsham, female gamete produced by Gynesham. If that two fuses, what two? Male gamete and female gamete fuses, it becomes fertilization. Fertilization takes place during which reproduction? Sexual reproduction. It means Andrewsham and Gynesham, they are directly involved in sexual reproduction. That's why this Andrewsham and Gynesham together called as a essential organs of a flower. Essential organs of a flower. Therefore, non-essential organs of a flower are what and what, sir? Calyx and corolla. Whereas essential organs of a flower, what, sir? Andrewsham and Gynesham. Is this statement clear? Right? Therefore, calyx plus corolla. Calyx plus corolla. Together called as what? Non-essential organs of a flower, right? Andrewsham and Gynesham. Together called as what? Essential organs of a flower. Essential organs of a flower. Is it okay? Right? Now, listen to this statement. Sir, calyx. Calyx is made up of sepals. Calyx made up of what, sir? Sepals. Whereas corolla is made up of petals. Corolla is made up of what, sir? Petals. Corolla is made up of petals. Sir, Andrewsham is made up of stamens. Andrewsham is made up of what, sir? Stamens. Andrewsham is made up of stamens. Whereas Gynesham or Gynosium made up of carpels. Made up of what, sir? Carpels. Sir, calyx is made up of sepals. Corolla is made up of petals. Andrewsham is made up of stamens. Gynesham is made up of what, sir? Carpels. Now listen to this statement. Calyx made up of what? Sepals. Therefore, sepals, unit of calyx. Corolla is made up of petals. Therefore, petals, unit of corolla. Andrewsham made up of what? Stamens. Therefore, stamens, unit of Andrewsham. What is the unit of Andrewsham? Stamens. Gynesham is made up of what? Carpels. Therefore, carpels, unit of what? Gynesham. Is it okay? Therefore, sepals, unit of calyx. Petals, unit of corolla. Stamens, unit of Andrewsham. Carpels, unit of Gynesham. Now listen to this statement carefully. Sir, sepals, petals, stamens and carpels, these are non-technical terms of a flower. Are they technical terms? No. These sepals, petals, stamens and carpels, these are non-technical terms of a flower. What are the non-technical terms of a flower? Sepals, petals, stamens and carpels. These are non-technical terms of a flower. Is it okay? Right. Parts of a flower. What is their unit? Right? First one is what's a calyx? What it is made up of? Sepals. Therefore, the unit of calyx is a sepals, right? Second one is a corolla. What it is? Corolla. Sir, corolla is made up of what? Petals. Therefore, what is a unit of a corolla petals? Number 3, androecium. What androecium is made up of? Stamens. Okay. Therefore, what is the unit of androecium, sir? Stamens. Next, number 4, gynoecium. Gynoecium, right? Sir, gynoecium, right, it is made up of what? Carpels. It is made up of carpels. Therefore, what is the unit of gynoecium? Carpels, right? Sir, these sepals, petals, stamens, and carpels, are they technical terms? They are non-technical terms of a flower. They are non-technical terms of a flower. They are non-technical terms of a flower. Is this statement okay? Right? In a flower, do you observe the stamens? Stamen. Take a stamen. Sir, how a stamen appears? Stamen or stamen? Pronunciation is different. That's it. Both means one and the same. Sir, this is a stamen. Each stamen contains two parts. Each stamen is having how many parts? Two parts. This fertile part is called as anther. What is this fertile part called as? Anther. Anther. Whereas this stalk is called as a filament. What it is called as a filament. Is it okay? Right? Therefore, each stamen is with how many parts, sir? Two parts. Each stamen is with two parts. What are the two parts, sir? First one is a anther. And the second one is a filament. Second one is what, sir? Filament. Now, see here. What is the first part? Anther. This is called anther. Sir, what is this, sir? This is lobe present in anther. Anther lobe. This is another anther lobe. Now you see, here how many anther lobes are present? Two anther lobes are present. So we are calling this anther as a dithicus anther. What is that anther called as? Dithicus anther. Therefore, anther may be dithicus or monothicus. It may be dithicus or what, sir? Monothicus. Monothicus. Now, see this diagram. Sir, here how many anther lobes are present? One anther lobe is present. We are calling this anther as a monothicus anther, right? Therefore, right, this dithicus anther, which anther, sir? Dithicus anther with how many anther lobes? Two anther lobes. It is with two anther lobes. Whereas monothicus anther is with how many anther lobes, sir? One anther lobe. It is with one anther lobe. Is it okay? Right. Now, sir, I am saying this as a anther lobe, right? In this anther lobe, pollen chambers are present. In anther lobe, what are present? Pollen chamber. This is a pollen chamber. Do you heard this word, pollen chamber? Sir, pollen chamber is also called as pollen sac. What is another name for pollen chamber? Pollen chamber is also called as pollen sac. This pollen sac is even called as microsporangium. What it is called as? Microsporangium. It is also called as microsporangium. Is it okay? Right. Therefore, sir, this is pollen chamber. Another name, pollen sac. Another name, microsporangium. Therefore, all these are what, sir? They are pollen chambers or pollen sacs or microsporangia. Now, listen this statement. Sir, inside this pollen chamber, pollen grains are produced. Inside what, sir? Pollen chamber. What are produced? Pollen grains are produced. Inside what? Pollen chamber. What are produced? Pollen grains are produced. inside the pollen chamber, what are produced? Pollen grains are produced. Sir, these pollen grains contains male gametes. These pollen grains, what they contains? They contains male gametes. Is it okay? Right. Therefore, sir, each stamen with how many parts? Two parts. What are they? Anther and filament. What are they? Anther and filament. Sir, this anther is made up of what, sir? Lobes. What are the lobes called as anther lobes? Sir, this is an anther lobe, this is another anther lobe, right? Okay, now, sir, dithecous anther with two anther lobes, whereas monothecous anther with one anther lobe. In anther lobe, what are present, sir? In anther lobe, pollen chambers are present. Inside pollen chambers, what are produced? Pollen grains are produced. This pollen grains contains what, sir? Male gametes. Contains male gametes. Now see this diagram. This is a dithecous anther. A dithecous anther is having how many pollen chambers? Which anther? Dithecous anther. With how many pollen chambers? Four pollen chambers. Now see this one. This is a monothecous anther. With how many anther lobes? With one anther lobe. It contains how many pollen chambers, sir? It contains two pollen chambers. Is it okay? Right? Therefore, a dithecous anther contains two anther lobes, four pollen chambers. Two anther lobes, four pollen chambers. Whereas a monothecous anther contains one anther lobe, right? How many pollen chambers? Two pollen chambers. How many pollen chambers? Two pollen chambers. Is this statement clear? Right? Now, take a gynecium. What is the unit of gynecium, sir? The unit of gynecium is a carpel. What is the unit of gynecium? Carpel. Sir, each carpel contains how many parts? Each carpel contains three parts. Each carpel is having how many parts? Three parts. Each carpel is having three parts. Sir, what are the three parts, sir? First one is stigma. Second one is a style. Third one is ovary. What it is? Ovary. Therefore, each carpel is with how many parts, sir? Three parts. What are the three parts? First one is a stigma. Stigma. Sir, in these three, who is terminal? The stigma is terminal. Who is terminal? The stigma is a terminal. Terminal. Okay. Right? Sir, this is stigma, this is ovary. In between these two, who is present? Style is present. Therefore, style is middle. It is going to connect the stigma with the ovary. Therefore, stigma, ovary, they are connected with the help of what, sir? Style. Is it okay? Right. Now go for the last part. What is that one? Ovary. What it is? Ovary. Now listen to this statement. Sir, this ovary contains a tissue called as placenta. This ovary contains a tissue called as what, sir? Placenta. Placenta. On placenta, ovules are present. On placenta, what are present? Ovules are present. Is it okay? Sir, this ovary is a basal part. Which part it is? Basal part. If fertilization takes place, ovary changes into true fruit. Yes or no? What changes into what? Ovary changes into true fruit when after fertilization. After fertilization, ovary changes into true fruit. Then what about ovules, sir? Sir, all these are ovules, right? After fertilization, ovules changes into seeds. What changes into what? Ovules changes into seeds. When after fertilization. After what? Fertilization. Therefore, see these statements carefully. Ovary, ovules. After what? Fertilization. After what, sir? Fertilization. After fertilization, what happens? Ovary. Listen here. After fertilization, ovary changes into what? True fruit. After fertilization, ovary changes into true fruit. Whereas after fertilization, ovules changes into what, sir? Seeds. Ovules changes into seeds. Is it okay? Right? Tomorrow we'll discuss the remaining part. Right? Thank you. Stay home, stay safe. Right.